As I mentioned, not all love is actually love. Now, misdirected love can be misdirected in many ways. There can be the wrong object, there can be the wrong method, there can be the wrong result. What do we mean by wrong object? Now, Ravan thought that he was actually loving Sita. But Sita was already married to Ram, and he had to regulate it. He thought, I'll make you my favorite queen. And Ravan, actually, he thought, I'm offering Sita a privilege. In fact, he did, he trash-talked Ram. He said, Ram is just a pauper. What is he giving you? I will give you the wealth unparalleled in the world. And he initially thought, actually, I'm doing something good for Sita. And he believed, or at least he imagined, that I will win Sita over. After all, I am so glorious. What woman can refuse me? And still, he had some suspicion. Maybe she will refuse initially, then I'll abduct her. So he thought that he was doing something good, but he did not think that I'm doing something wrong. He had no moral sense. He thought that. So there are many people who may act out of selfish desire, but they may think it is love. So when some emotion is directed toward what do you mean by wrong object? It's an object that goes against the principles of dharma. Then that is not love. It may seem like love, but it's not love. Sometimes it may be the wrong method. So Kaikeyi, she loved Bharat. And it was natural for a mother to want to protect the interests of her son. But there was no threat for Bharat. Ram and Bharat, they had the best of relationship. And Ram was not going to deprive Bharat of everything. Ram didn't see Bharat as a rival. And Bharat didn't see himself as Ram's rival. So she loved Bharat. And she thought she was taking care of Bharat. But she went about it by a completely wrong way. So, for a mother to love her child is not wrong, but what we do because of that love, that may be wrong at times. Now, sometimes it can be a wrong result. Dhritarashtra was told that your son has demoniac characteristics. And those who are wise, and in those times they could see right from the birth what kind of characteristics a child has, and especially because he was born with very inauspicious signs. There were jackals who were making all kinds of sounds, and they're all various inauspicious omens. So Vidura said, abandon this child. You will have 99 other children. Just abandon this one child. Of course, it's difficult for a father to abandon the child, but he was not just a father. He was a king. He should have abandoned, but he didn't. He thought, I'm loving my child. But what happened? In the name of loving his child, he ended up pampering him. He ended up unwittingly empowering the dark side within Vidura, within Duryodhana, till Duryodhana became demoniac. So now sometimes we may use the word attachment, we may use the word lust, we may use the word illusion. These words are different. But people who are doing it, they may think it is actually love. So it's not love. So we need intelligence to understand this. It's remarkable in this world that even people who do terrible things, very few of them actually think that they're doing terrible things. Criminals, when they're caught, sometimes criminals, there was one serial killer in America several decades ago. He just went around killing so many people. And finally he was caught. And then that was the time when people were studying sociopaths. The psychologist asked him to write his story. Why did you do all this? And he wrote out the story in such a way that he thought that, actually, I did it for my loved ones. I did it out of love. He killed hundreds of people, and he thought he's doing it out of love. So just because we think that we are loving, that doesn't necessarily mean we are loving. We need to educate our intelligence to understand what is love. So intelligence reveals what is love and exposes what is masquerading as love. So sometimes, because love is such a powerful emotion, the forces of illusion in this world sometimes put on that masquerade to be able to manipulate us. And unless we are well astute, we will not know what is actually love and what is simply coming off as love.